Coming up, I'm going to tell you the very beginning of one of the coolest Arthurian legends out there, the Green Knight. Let's get started. Hi everybody, I'm Lee, and welcome to Grimley's Fiends. If you're brand new to the channel, welcome. Glad to see you here. Every week we focus on new monsters and creatures, as well as some mythology and legends that have sprung up throughout civilization. It's a lot of fun. It's a personal passion project of mine. Who am I exactly? I'm a writer, illustrator, and sculptor, and for the last 12 years, I've been creating my own monsters and critters called Grimley's Fiends. We published a coloring book, it did pretty well, and we have a Patreon account where we share a lot of our original drawings, monsters, and creations for our patrons to download and color if that's what they want to do. But personally, for me, it's all about the monsters. This week, I'm really excited about a brand new movie that's coming out from A24. It's an adaptation of The Green Knight, which is one of the oldest stories we have in English literature. It's such a prominent and influential work that even people like J.R.R. Tolkien cited as one of the major influences on their careers and their writing style. And it's a document that was almost lost to us forever. The one sole surviving manuscript was almost destroyed in a fire some time ago. So that's all we have. Otherwise, we would have had to rely on oral tradition to tell this incredible story. It's got just about everything you could ever want. Romance, palace intrigue, politics, and beheading. What's not to like? Before we get into the story, if you like what we're doing here at Grimley's, please hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. We're going to keep the fresh, spooky, cool content coming. And now, The Green Knight. Or at least, the beginning of The Green Knight. So the story takes place during the New Year's festivities at Camelot. Arthur's really tired. He's been king for quite some time. He's in his middle years now, and he's pretty much seen and done everything there is to see and do. So he looks around his assembled guests, his knights, his courtesans, everybody else that's assembled there at Camelot, and he says, "Show me a wonder or a glorious tale, something to pass through these endless festivities." And almost on cue, the banquet hall doors crash open, and in rides this massive figure, completely decked out in green. His armor's green, his leathers are green, even the horse he's riding on is green. He rides this gigantic horse of his up to the center dais in the banquet hall, and he unsheathes this huge, just gnarly looking axe. It's incredibly well crafted, but it's massive. Like, it would take a normal person at least both hands to be able to wield it effectively. He holds this axe up to the heavens and he says, "Greatest of kings, I have a game for you, unlike any you have ever seen." Now, the knights of Camelot, they're a little freaked out by all of this. They jump to their feet, they unsheath their swords, they're ready to fight this guy because he's challenged their king. But Arthur realizes that there's something else going on with this guy, and he waves his knights to stand down. They're not in a huge hurry to do so, but they eventually settle down. The Green Knight gets down from his horse, and he says, "The game's rules are simple. Any champion bold enough to take my own axe and deliver to me their mightiest blow is welcome to keep this axe in return. If I survive, in 1 year's time, that knight will come to my castle, the Green Chapel, where they will receive an equal blow in kind." Now, all of the assembled knights were in such a hurry to jump up and defend their king just a few moments ago. They kind of take it easy at this point because, well, they've either been questing for a long time, they've been challenged by personal ordeals, maybe some of them are a little drunk, but I think a lot of them have been dealing with some supernatural creatures in their own right. They're not in a huge hurry to get involved again. But in attendance here in Arthur's court is Gawain. Gawain is Arthur's nephew by his sister Morgause, and he is newly knighted. He's desperate to prove himself. He's very keen to show Arthur what he's made of and to prove his honor to all of the assembled knights. So he jumps to his feet and he says, "I'll take up this challenge. I'll play your game." And the Green Knight chuckles to himself and then says to the assembled knights, "Well, this boy has more courage than anyone else here." That kind of gets under Gawain's hide just a little bit, because you can make fun of a knight, you can challenge his martial prowess, you could maybe make fun of his lineage just a little bit, but what you don't want to do is mock his honor. So Gawain's a little hot under the collar at this point. He takes up the Green Knight's axe. It is massive. It is incredibly heavy, and it takes everything Gawain has to grip this axe in both hands. He swings it back over his head. The knight chuckles, "Do your best, boy." And Gawain swings down severing the Green Knight's head from his neck. The assembled court of Camelot gasps. This is far more gruesome than anything they were expecting. The head rolls gently to Gawain's feet. The body staggers back just a bit. Gawain looks about, himself a little bit shocked. Didn't realize he had it in him. But at least this mystical nonsense is over, and maybe he can get back to his drink. The head of the Green Knight starts laughing again and says, "Well struck, boy. Remember our bargain struck." And the body staggers over to its own severed head, picks it up, mounts its green horse, and rides out of the banquet hall, laughing maniacally. Everybody's stunned. No one expected things to get quite so weird. But Gawain, on the other hand, has a whole other expression on his face. He's realized that he's bound himself to a game of honor. You can't get into a beheading game with someone who can survive his own decapitation. Gawain knows he has 1 year to settle his affairs and ride forth to his own certain death. He is a knight of the Round Table, after all, and his honor is everything. Now, the rest of the story you can either see in the upcoming movie from David Lowery and A24, The Green Knight, which I'll be seeing tonight. Very excited about it. I'll have my full review up here in a few days. Or you can read one of the books that has been written over the last 100 years or so. I've left links below in the information section where you can pick up the books and read the story for yourself. It's fantastic. It's full of all kinds of magical creatures, questing, a little bit of romance, a little bit of rivalry, a kissing game. Go figure. And of course, the Green Knight looms above all of this, as well as Gawain's pretty grim fate. Now, I should let you know up front, those are affiliate links. So if you do buy any of those books, I will receive a small commission, which of course we'll use to help support this channel. But I'd love to hear what you think. Do you enjoy the story of the Green Knight? Are you familiar with the story of the Green Knight? Or is this your first time coming across it? Are there other Arthurian legends that you'd like to see us cover here at Grimley's Fiends? I am game to draw them all. This stuff is like catnip to me. And that drawing time lapse that played during the story, we'll have that available for all of our Patreon supporters, which they can download in color if they'd like. Thanks so much for tagging along with me for the story of the Green Knight. It's one of my favorites of old medieval literature. The character himself could be an old pagan holdover. He could be the Green Man of old Celtic myth that just carried over into this story. And these are the kind of stories that get me fired up because we can see the roots of our own mythology and our own contemporary fairy tales in all of these old, old stories. And that's one of the things that we like to do here at Grimley's Fiends, is explore the past and celebrate the present. Whether it's the fantastic creatures and monsters that we see in our comic books and movies, or if it's our own creations and fairy tales. Like one of the stories that I created here on Grimley's, it's the story of Iope. She's a forest princess who gets into just a little more than she bargained for while wandering through the haunted woods. If you like these kind of stories and you like what we're doing here, again, please hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. I'm absolutely thrilled with the reception Grimley's has received since we relaunched the channel just a few short weeks ago. Thanks so much for being a part of that, everybody. The best is yet to come.